come. Come, there's some Jay, come. Come, some Jay, come. Come. Come put us, come. Come. Where are you going? Come. There's nothing in there, says Angie. Come here. eh? Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. This is your girl Electros 1115. And the video that I did yesterday, this is a follow-up. So what I did, I reached out to one of my good friends where I used to work. He was a vet there for the dogs, and vet technician there for the dogs where I used to work. And we kind of developed somewhat of a friendship, and he was the person who gave me the puss perfume as I did in the bathing the cat in the video. I'll leave a link down in the description below. When I was bathing the cat, I used a puss perfume. He's the person who gave it to me. So because of this incident with my cat now, where he has screw worms, I reached out to him and he was saying it's a real bad situation. So what he's going to do is to help me out with this situation. So we have everything set up here now. We have some medicine going on, so I don't know where they're for. I'll show you. Show you. And here we have Mr. Wilson, famous Mr. Wilson. So he's going to be helping me out. So you ready?
Yeah.
Alright, so I'm about to shake up the thing. Keep me out of the house in
there. Eh?
I'm going to close in there, so watch me and take it out.
Where are
you? In there, on us. Come on. Come, Jay. Come, put us. You're supposed to look through the screen while you're meditating. Make sure you keep panic for some more, sir.
Yeah,
good man, you wash me.
Alright, what we're looking at here is a small incision called amyelitis. Basically, it's been infected, so what we're going to do is try to get the infection out.
Yeah.
Right, so she used antibiotic and so on, and so we're going to check it there. The sickness, the infection out. Also the cat is not looking bad. It seems like it's a male, I'm not sure.
Yeah, it's a male.
Well, it's a male cat here.
Alright,
if you notice here, we had a maggot infestation. So what took place, apparently, what she did was really interesting. It's an,
it hasn't gone to the brain, so it's not causing a problem to the brain right now.
Great.
And so what we're looking at now, there's going to be with some one-to-one,
put an antibiotic on to control any other inflammation that might be there. You understand? After we put antibiotic, we're also going to leave some antibiotic for him to be given. You understand?
But cats like these, once they have pain, biologically they normally treat themselves.
Because we now put them in our world, they are now at this level.
So our first step here is to drop a particular liquid on the inside.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. If you zoom in, you're not pain, man. You're going to zoom in on your head. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So once you put the liquid on the inside, it will help to control any other infection that might be there.
This take away mellitus. Mellitus are like fly. You ever hear about a bob fly and then type of fly there?
Yeah.
And those type of fly, pardon my friend, sorry. Those type of flies. So it actually controls them. Now, mm-hmm. once you have fly problem, you're going to get maggots.
Yeah.
When you get maggots, then we have hell breaking loose.
Because remember, I have a small cut on the ears, you know, but right. me never did take it for nothing.
Well, what you have done was very interesting, actually. You treated it. You did your, basically, you're a little vet yourself.
I'm going to take out more than 100 maggots out of it.
Alright, this burns a little. The reason why, it actually taking out what's in there now. Mm-hmm. So you get that burning sensation. I'm a bit surprised the cat is very calm. Normally cats are actually up in the face long time till they hide.
But him alright though.
Yeah man.
I don't know if somebody said to me probably you don't make it.
No man, you make it man. What we're doing now is actually we're not going to inject the cut, we're actually throwing the liquid on the inside.
Oh. And that burn?
Yeah.
Oh. So dead in his skin that it won't burn him so much?
We have antibiotic that we use.
Oh.
So okay. It actually, once you do that, we just give him the antibiotic, it will get rid of the pain.
Oh, okay. I never see so much maggot in all my life, or animal.
Alright, wash, wash. Yes, as you can see, it's actually working its way now. Now, these are tissue. So when it heals up back, mm-hmm. as you know about, they call the platelet. Platelet mm-hmm. will grow back over it. Mm-hmm. So this is normal here, we're looking at here. Mm-hmm. But we're checking for it to find if there's any maggots or something inside, right?
Okay.
Notice we don't see any maggot things there. What we're seeing there is actually the wound itself. Mm-hmm. Understand?
So often a cat must go visit a vet?
Cats can come in as often as you can, and it depends on what you're looking for.
As often as I can?
Yes.
So like every year? Once a year?
Once a year would be better.
Yeah.
Most people bring them in like 3 times for the week. Let's be frank here. It depends on what the cat has. So for example, if he has a worm condition, either tapeworm or he might have some bacterial or viral infection, you can actually bring the cat to the vet.
Yeah, I know when they're sick, but I mean like regular checkup.
Every six months?
Every
6 months,
okay.
Yeah. But for a serious visit, as often as you can fix it.
Okay.
So one of the things we always advise people to do is that don't wait until the cut comes.
So like, oh, missy the little cut, should I just bring him in?
Because remember now, a small cut becomes a huge cut.
The thing is, you know, the man is a foot on him and he always heal up afterwards.
Really?
So, yeah, so.
Now, the thing with cat bodies, different from canine.
Because if you look underneath here, so you see a big cut underneath here, so. And belly part there, so. Or the other side. See there?
Oh.
And it heal up. And it heal up by itself. So, I never think nothing about my guitar.
Do you
want? And the ears now for chop off and I'm not like
that. No one. Alright, the wound powder will be put on the cut itself.
Mm-hmm.
What, as I said, what you're doing is good. Mm-hmm. Very, very good. What we need to do is to give yourself antibiotics. Problem.
So wait, the antibiotics are injection something?
It's just a one antibiotic.
So I have to inject him?
No man, I'll do all of that.
Oh.
I'm going to leave some for you to give in the mouth.
No, in the mouth, so that's the one. Because he went fight me yesterday. But him calm today. And him get out of the cube when I didn't have him in there.
I burn him.
You're okay, Zumje.
No, what the antibiotic does now, the wound powder, it actually helps to heal the wound itself.
Mm-hmm.
As I can tell you, it's the first I'm really dealing with a cat that is this calm.
Really?
Yes.
Because I'm in a pain, that's
right. In all my 20 years of working with animals, I've never really come across
them. You never want to see him yesterday then? You wouldn't want to see him yesterday then?
Well, see the news, it might take time to shut down, so we know that ignorance is a bad thing.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you need to do?
Yeah.
You might get angry now. Oh, like you want to defend yourself now.
One of the best ways
so you know, say you're going to be in bed now.
Yep. Mm-hmm. One of the best ways to put on powders on cats or any animal, instead of to put it on spray it, it's normally easier if you dab it on a piece of cotton and put it to that. Because when you spray it, especially the spray ones, it causes a lot of problems.
Oh, that's why I never know if I don't size my spray, Mr. Day. You should
be like this, if they feel more quiet,
yeah,
and they get more easier to trust you and work with you.
Oh, okay.
When you have this spray and you're going like this now, then you are looking for a fight.
Okay.
So there's always going to be a winner, and I can guarantee you that.
I know. So often you think I should put this wound powder on him?
This wound powder will go on as often as possible. So we're talking like once morning, once evening.
Yeah.
Understand? Rest will after some fish. That's a lot.
Okay.
Alright.
Hey, Sumjay.
Come here, put this.
So this is the antibiotics?
Yeah. Alright.
Hello.
Okay, hello.
Went out, so we're going to leave back again. Turn it over. Alright. If you notice, we are reaching a stage of where he's actually. Cats don't like to be angry very too often.
No, that pussy, he's different.
Really?
You love when you angle him. You don't mean anything that you love the whole day. And you rub him down.
So this is a painkiller that gets rid of the pain.
And then move your head on the end, can't do that. So it's gonna make him sleep a lot too.
No, this doesn't put him to sleep, it actually gets rid of pain.
Mm-hmm.
Once you have maggots wound, you know, I want to get rid of pain off it. So that's actually a good pain killer.
Okay.
But we're gonna do a physical check now. It means that we're checking to see if any more pulses is on the body and stuff like that.
And the thing is, I buy dry food for him and him used to eat it a lot and he put on good amount of weight and then all of a sudden
him not get better, he comes right back around.
No, but even before him have the cut, he's like he never did eat the dry food.
So you need to put on vitamin? Yeah.
No, but you see if I give him like the tin mackerel or the tuna or them something, then he eat it.
Okay.
I have no money to buy tuna and mackerel for puss every day. The dry food, like I buy 2 bag of it for the month. Uh-huh. 1 bag of like $600. So I spend at least $1,200 per month for food for him, but he not eat it. But I guess because this is the festival, why I never do that eat it. But a good while now, and he lose a lot of weight.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Nice boy.
You done it, Jim?
Yeah.
Alright. Hey, Zoom J.
Spoiled.
You're not going in there today, sorry. I'll go back to the spot. Thank you so very much, Dr. Wilson.
Thank you.
Are you going for my legs, Zoom G?
No, you can't balance on this. Hmm? Put us? Come. Come. Come.
Where are you going? Hmm, sir? Where are you going? Scratch your sick ears. You can't scratch it, Putus.
Still smell like a stinky.
Stinky ass. Stinky ass. Hey, Zonje. Put us. Talking to. Why you going to piss up my bed? Huh? She's a piece. I'm not even left you. Not even left you one good hour. Good end. Just going to piss up my bed. Piss up all my pillow to rotted. Zumje? Zumje? Come outside here. Come outside. Yeah? Something there out. Zumje. Zumje. Pizza. Pizza puss. Pisser. So people, after me feel say, I just two of my pillow and catch piss. Okay. Zoom J piss up three of my pillow them one time. That little bugger in the box over there, so. That little bugger piss up three pillow one time. Let me see. Hi, sir. Zoom J.
Sheet on the inside.
So what you do last night? Please don't tell me to piss up nothing more in our shit no way. We eat our food and dinner. It's good, eh? I'm gonna look in here a little bit. Kissing and shitting. Here? Yeah? You listen here? Your box is for kissing and shitting. Not my head. Zumje, please don't come in yourself. Please don't go in the closet. Please. Hello? Okay. Isn't it? But get up, thinking about a morning time too. What your mouth smell so? Hi. Hi, sir. Hi. Hi. more pissing in the bed here. Hear them there? No more pissing in the bed. No shitting. Okay? You put us? After me there with the puss, good, you know, look what I can do. Piss in the bed again. And me just change the sheet last night. Zoom Jay? I'm sorry, you know, but you have to stay outside now, you know. I am so sorry. Me can't deal with this. Let me literally can't deal with this because Zoom Jay stay in the bed and piss up the bed again. Like, what you have to say for yourself? Huh? Come on, I can't deal with you. I can't deal with you. I piss up a bed too much time.
You have to start to stay outside now, here. I can't deal with you on the bed.
Thank you. Peekaboo. Peekaboo.